One day, Al-Mutawakkil al-Abbasi. Al-Mutawakkil al-Abbasi became sick. Al-Mutawakkil's mother, his mother, she asked Imam al-Hadi, she said to him, can you teach him some dua, something to do, give him some remedy, you know, give him a cure, whatever it is, give him some medicine, something. And if he cures him, if Allah cures him, I will have a gift for you. The Imam Salamullah said, I don't need your gift, but I will give him something. Yes. Even though Mutawakkil was the enemy of the Imam, Mutawakkil used to imprison the Imam. You know. Imam Salamullah alayhi gave him some remedy, and indeed he was cured. His mother then, the mother of Mutawakkil, sent him a bag with 10,000 dirhams in it, 10,000 silver coins as a gift. And she had stamped it. She had, you know, she had a stamp, so she stamped the bag, the seal. She sealed it and stamped it. She gave it to the Imam. Imam said, oh, we don't need it. But she said, no, no, please. You know, this is a gift. So the Imam kept it. Mutawakkil al-Abbasi, one day, a few days later, somebody comes to him and tells him, do you know that this Ali, you know, Ali al-Hadi, he received so much money, khoms and things like this, his Shia, and he's trying to use this money against you to raise an army to fight against you. He says, really? He says, yes. He says, guards, go to his house. Any money you find, seize it and bring it to me. And bring him to me as well too. So the guards storm the Imam's house. Salamullahi alayhi. They storm his house. They find him in the musalla, praying. They search all his house. The only bag of money they find is this one bag, 10,000 dirhams. They arrest the Imam, they come. They bring the money to the Imam, to the Mutawakkil. Mutawakkil says, where did you get this money from? He said, from your mother. Look at the bag. He looks at the bag. He says, yes, this is really the seal of my mother, the stamp of my mother. That's right. Why did she give you this money? He says, because you became ill and she asked me to help you. So I did. So then he became embarrassed. Mutawakkil, he said, okay, we apologize. I'm sorry, Ibn Rasulullah. You know, I'm sorry what we did to you. I will give you another 10,000 dirhams. You take this money as well and you go as a gift for you. So it goes. But Mutawakkil dies. The other leaders, the other khulafa, they became, unfortunately, afraid of the Imam, salamullahi alayhi, jealous of the Imam, salamullahi alayhi. So unfortunately, he was given the poison at the age of about 42, approximately, in Samarra. Imam al-Hasan al-Askari was next to him as he sees his father suffering the pain of the poison. It's very painful, brothers and sisters. May Allah not make a mu'min or an individual experience it. But you know, sometimes when you experience some stomach pain, if you've experienced stomach pain in the past, you see how painful it is, how much you want to rest and just want to relax and just don't want to sleep. Imagine if there is poison, wal-iyadu billah. So that pain started overtaking the Imam salamullahi alayhi until his final moments when he gave his wasiyah to Imam al-Askari alayhi salam to be buried in his house. Imam al-Hadi salamullahi alayhi then said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna jaddi Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. And his soul left his body. Imam al-Askari, salamullahi alayhi, of course, cried for the loss of his father, but did as his father ordered him to do, did his ghusl, kafan, and buried the father, al-Imam al-Hadi, in his house. And that is when you go today, inshallah, if you ever go for the ziyarah in Samarra, you are in the house of the Imam, salamullahi alayhi. That's his house, which, alhamdulillah, Allah, out of his grace, and out of those greatness of Ahlul Bayt, that house became now a big shrine, walhamdulillah, with a large qubba. It is the largest diameter of the qubba, of the domes, of all the Ma'sumin's shrine. The largest diameter is the diameter of Al-Askariyayn alayhim as-salam. And he buried his father, Ghareeb, in Samarra. I say, Ibn Rasulullah, At least when you left this dunya, ayyuhal Imam al-Hadi, salamullahi alayhi, although your loss is painful to your Shia, it's painful to your children, but you had Imam al-Askari next to you, you had your family, some of those family members were with you, there were some Shia here and there, they took care of your ghusl, kafan, burial, but who was there on the day of Ashura? For Abi Abdullah al-Husayn, salamullahi alayhi, all alone in Karbala. And nobody is there except Zainab, salamullahi alayha, his sister, his women, his children. Zainab, salamullahi alayha, comes next to her body, to the body of her brother, a body without a head. She raises the body and she says, Allahumma taqabbal minna hadha al-qurba ya ya ya. Oh Allah, accept this sacrifice from us. And then she goes to a nearby hill known as today as the Hill of Zainabiyya. She stands over the hill, turns towards Medina and cries, As-salamu alayka ya jadda ya, ya Rasool Allah. Hada Husaynuka fil araya, maslub al-imamati wal-ridaya. This is your Hussein, Gharib in Karbala. Ya, ya, ya. The enemies of Allah burned the tents of Ahlulbayt alayhimus salam. As their children were running from one place to another place, Umar ibn Sa'ad la'anahullah asked orders 50 knights to crush over the body of Abi Abdullah al-Hussein in front of his family, his children. They see the body of Abi Abdullah cut into pieces, then crushed by the enemies of Allah, by the horses of the enemies of Allah. One of the daughters of Abi Abdullah al-Hussein rushes to the river of Furat. Is she thirsty? Does she want to drink? No. She heard her uncle Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas is next to the river of Furat. So she ran there. She saw the body of her uncle. His hands are on his side. She throws herself on the body of her uncle, covered with arrows, covered with spears, an arrow in his eye, arrows in his chest, and she cries, Aywa Amma ya, Aywa Abbas, oh my uncle Abu al-Fadl, they killed my father Abi Abdullah, and now they are crushing his body under with the horses of Bani Umayyah. My uncle Ya Abbas, they are burning our tents, they're attacking us. Ya uncle Ya Abbas, I wish you would come back to protect us, look after us, see us. Some of the poets take this scene and they put it into verses of poetry where they say, as if Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas replies to her, as if he talks to her and says, my little girl, if I had my right hand, if I can get my left hand back, if I can have the arrow removed from my eye, I would stand up again to defend you. I would have not let this allow to happen to you. Inna lillah وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ